interview will be done in the hip-hop style.
Wizants
to get shizzy with the nizzy.
Yo, Barbara.
We are here in the beautiful Galaxy offices in the Old Port of Montreal for Pause Play with Canada's very own Monkey Junk. How you guys doing?
Is that
doing good?
Amen.
You guys want to introduce yourself? Tell us what you do in the band.
I'm Tony D and I play guitar.
I'm Matt Saab and I play the drum set.
I'm Steve Mariner. I play guitar, sing, and the harmonica.
He's a big shot.
So, I mean, right off the bat, Monkey Junk. What is Monkey Junk? What's the history behind the name?
There's an old blues guy from the 30s all the way to 70s named Son House. He was a purveyor of Delta blues, you know, right up there with Robert Johnson and then Muddy Waters after that. And he has a quote where he's talking about blues and he says, I'm talking about the blues, I ain't talking about monkey junk. And we just, you know, I saw that at some point and thought Monkey Junk would be a funny name for a band, held on to it. And then a few years after, an opportunity to play with these fellas presented itself and we just decided that would be the name.
So how would you guys describe your sound? What's the sound of Monkey Junk?
Well, it starts with blues. That's the roots, but we've got a pretty wide variety of influences that we let seep in there. We like to rock, and you know, we like funk music, soul music, you know, a lot of different flavors, and we just kind of put it all in the pot, stir it around, and what comes out is Monkey Junk.
That's exactly what it is. It's a pile of Monkey Junk. Yeah. So you guys are kind of on the end of your Canadian tour you're doing. So what can we expect next? Where are you going after this?
Well, we are definitely, we're traveling to Europe quite a bit this year. That's going to be great. And we're going to like Eastern Europe, like Poland and Slovakia.
Have you been to any of these places before?
Not Poland, first time
visits?
Yeah. Then we're going to Sweden too.
Sweden.
Yeah, that's going to be
Austria.
All right. Yeah, Austria, Germany, Czech Republic. Then we're going to the States in between, I think we're doing, is it in between? No, we're going to be back in Canada in between Poland and Sweden. We have to come back and then come back out there. So we're doing that, and we're going to probably start recording some new material.
Killer.
Yeah.
So when you guys are on tour, you know, what are some creature covers that you have to have? What do you need when you're away from home?
Whiskey.
Not the first band to answer that, yeah?
I don't know. That's a good point.
We all have our iPods. You know, music is... you know, being able to listen to good music without, you know, because we kind of get sick of the sound of each other's voices after a while.
I can see that.
Long
drives
in the van.
Crocheting needles.
We got to put the
crocheting needles.
I'm more of a knitter myself.
That's right. Yeah. You want a scarf? I'll make you one.
I would love one.
You got to see it.
If you could match this shirt, I would really, truly appreciate it.
Yeah. That's a hard color to get, though.
Well, don't get the exact color, but maybe a complementary color might be nice.
Right.
Come on, you don't crochet. I can just tell by your answer you don't crochet. Yeah. Anything sneaky on your iPods that you might not want to admit that's on your iPods right now?
Oh, we have the guilty pleasures. We do that.
Oh, yeah, Christina Aguilera.
Entire collection?
No,
or are
song.
We talking
just
about
one song?
That's not, I don't know. That's a good tune, man.
You know? It is a good song. You know, Ain't No Other Man.
Ain't no other man but moves and what you do. I have Sade.
Do your thing.
Sade?
Yes.
Who on earth is Sade? You talking about Sade?
Sade. I call her Sade.
Sade?
In our day, we called her Sade.
Or Shade. Yes. Or Shady. Or no one could ever pronounce
Sade.
That name.
Sade.
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 Sade. Sade. Yeah, I love
Sade works. That's just as fine.
Yeah.
So we asked the last band that we interviewed to ask you guys a question. So here it is.
Hey, how's it going, guys? We're Headley, but we don't know who you are, but maybe we do. We haven't found out yet. So if we know you, hey, nice to see you again. And if we haven't, well, nice to meet you. We got a question for you.
Just curious. At the end of a long, hard day when you've been emotionally drained and you're ready for bed and you still get to hang out with fans and people you don't know that want pictures or just a bit of your time, how do you deal with that? What do you do psychologically to make sure that you're still positive and making it a great experience for everybody?
Hmm. Good question, Headley. you know, my personal feeling is, you know, people have paid good money to come see our shows. The least we could do is shake a few hands and sign a few CDs at the end of the night. It's not that big of a deal for us. We're more than happy to do it. It means someone's actually taking the time to buy our CDs or our toques or t-shirts, and you know, it's really not that big of a deal.
I'm willing to bet that our fans are a little more tame than Headley's fans.
Yeah.
But I find that alcohol helps.
Alcohol. So pretty much alcohol for every question could have been the answer, really.
From
your point of view?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, that's fine. So you guys have taken home 20 Maple Blues Awards since 2008. You took home the 2013 Juno Award for Blues Album of the Year. You guys
2012.
Were 2012 Juno?
2012, yeah. Yep.
Edit that out. 2012 Juno. So you guys were back at the Junos recently. Tell me what that was like for you guys.
Oh, man, it was a wicked party. We went to Winnipeg, and we've always had a great time playing in Winnipeg. We have lots of musician friends there, so we were looking forward to it for as soon as we found out that we were nominated. There's a great bar there called the Times Changed High and Lonesome Club that we've played at many times, and lots of great music happens at. So we spent some time there. We played there. Matt and I got to play in the Juno Cup charity hockey game, which was awesome. We got to play with, you know, other great Canadian musicians, Jim Cuddy, you know, who else was on the team this year?
Not the first time Jim Cuddy's been on that team either with you.
Jim's the captain.
Yeah, he picks it.
Yeah.
This is your second time playing in the Juno Cup.
This is our second time, yeah.
And they had two of the women from the national team, gold medal winners.
Yeah.
They slammed you then.
Yes, they did.
Pretty
yeah.
well.
Yeah, fair enough. I understand.
Yeah. I love watching the players, you know, like the NHL players take one stride, they'll take another stride, and they've covered everything. And I love watching these guys just like getting in there, you know.
And some of them played against two former Montreal Canadiens captains, Mark Napier and Mike Keane. That was very cool.
Well, I can't even stand up straight on skates. So I'm waiting for summer. That's all I'm saying. I'm excited. So the new album is All Frequencies. Tell me about writing this album.
Usually, which is the same way we always write an album, we'll get a riff, a groove. Sometimes we will have lyrics.
But not usually.
Yeah. No, but it's strange. Like, you know, we've done like that a lot. We've come in, like even in the album before this, I remember just doing these songs where we would start and we would play and the progression would come out and there'd be no lyrics ready. And then eventually we would come up with the lyrics and kind of did this the same way almost, but this album, though, for me, defines the sound of Monkey Junk more than any, like, by a long shot, actually. So this is what we really have turned into, is so All Frequencies.
Tell me about the new single, You Make a Mess.
Well, we actually, the riff of You Make a Mess, like the main hook, came from a little ad-lib section from another song that we would do live. And often what happens with our songs is we'll do a lot of jamming on stage, and then we'll take little snippets of what we do and then develop them in the whole song. So we did that, and then Tony had the idea of You Make a Mess, mm-hmm. and then we just kind of made a song. Right, it's not a very deep song, you know, it's just it's about getting down and having fun. So, you know, we just wrote the lyrics, and that one actually came together pretty quick, you know. Yeah. It was just a groove that we knew worked because, like I said, we played it, and then we just had some fun with it. And
And the riff was already there from jamming through the years, right?
Yeah, just felt natural.
I noticed there's no bass player. Is that a choice you've made?
Yes.
Or yes, it is.
Yes. They're always the strangest ones of any band. So, I mean, we have enough strange as it is. We leave that one out. And, you know.
I think I took that the wrong way there.
No, there was never really a bass player. Like, when we started, it was just, seriously, when we first started this band, you know, small pub back in Ottawa called Irene's, and just, we used to sit down and be two guitars and drums in the middle. Very tiny instruments, you know, like tiny amps. It's not like that anymore. But Steve should tell him what you actually do, which is really cool.
Yeah, I play a baritone guitar, so it's tuned a fifth lower than a regular guitar. And in previous situations, before Monkey Junk existed, when I would play baritone guitar and there'd be a bass player, we'd always be walking on each other because they occupy some of the same kind of sonic space.
Absolutely.
I don't know. The way we play guitar together, like, he plays a lot of really cool lead stuff, and I also play bass, so I think more like a bass player and like a rhythm guy. So what he does kind of sits on top of what I do, but there's all this room for the baritone to, you know, explore the space.
Yeah. I mean, the style is Steve and I played a lot of sort of solo shows, and we do Delta blues styles where you're just using your thumb a lot to ride the bass strings on a guitar and then the high strings of the melody. When you do a lot of solo shows, you know, people like Robert Johnson or Son House and just, you know, Mississippi John Hurt kind of material where you're just, you're finger picking. So you're always riding the low bass. So we started doing that at the beginning. So that's how we would cover a lot of, I still have that bad habit of trying to cover absolutely anything because there's no bass, but we don't really need it anymore.
I don't think it's missed, to be honest with you.
No,
you can hear Monkey Junk on Galaxy's The Blues Channel as well as the Galaxy Canadiana channel. Tune in, listen to them. Thank you guys so much for coming. You going to play some tunes for us?
Thanks, you bet.
Tune in next time, guys. Thanks so much.